So you have your new Arlo camera and you're tired of changing those batteries, so you're looking into the solar panel. But is it worth the $80 investment per panel? In today's video, we are going to look into that and see if it's worth it, so stay tuned. Hey everyone, my name is Steve from the channel Steve Does, and I want to thank you for joining me here at reviews.org. Now, Arlo does have two different versions of the solar panel. In today's video, we are actually just going to be covering the one with the magnetic connection. So that is only going to be currently for the Ultra and the Pro 3 cameras. When I initially picked up my cameras and I knew that a battery was going to need to be charged, say every 2 to 4 months, I was like, that's not going to be that bad. I can change it. It's a quick take it down, charge it, whatever it is, put it back up there. But it's kind of been an annoyance. I get the notification, the battery's 10%. I'm like, oh man, like I don't want to do that right now. Battery eventually dies, especially if you have your cameras up really high. I know that some of you have commented that you want to put your cameras up high in a tree or on the second story of your house, not something that is easily accessible. So you're interested in getting this solar panel. A couple other things that I wanted to know with the solar panel is that, does it turn on certain features that require AC power? For example, activity zones and the 3 second look back. Both of those require the cameras to be plugged in, but if I have this set up with it getting power from the sun, will it turn those features on? Well, those are all things that we're gonna be talking about in today's video. But before we get started, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on future videos like this one. Also, all the products I'm going to talk about in this video, we are going to have linked in the description below so you guys can check those out. With all that said, let's get started. All right, so a solar panel is pretty straightforward. If we look inside the box, it really just comes with two things. It comes with the panel itself with an 8-foot charging cable. We've got the magnetic mount on the other side, like I mentioned before, for the Ultra and the Pro 3 cameras. Not compatible with the Pro or the Pro 2, so make sure you keep that in mind. And then it also comes with a wall mount. Now, this is one of the heavier duty wall mounts, not the one that came with the camera, which seemed to be pretty cheap and plastic. This one is all metal and a lot heavier duty. So one thing that I am interested to find out is one side of my house where I have my camera on, it does not get a lot of sun. It is the first side of my house to get full shade. So I would say the amount of sun that I'm gonna get a day, I mean, depending on the season, is gonna be anywhere from maybe 2 to 4 hours of sun. Now, is that gonna be enough to keep the camera topped off? That is something that I want to find out and we'll be looking at today. So let's actually go outside and I'll show you guys the setup that I have. So like I mentioned, I have a camera above my front door on the side of the house that gets the most shade. I'm getting currently about 3 hours of sun a day. If you take a look at this time lapse, I'm losing sun about 11 a.m. So it's not even noon and the sun is gone over there. But I'm happy to say that that panel is getting enough sun to keep the camera topped off. In fact, there's enough residual light in the area that it is actually still providing some power to the camera, even though it is in the shade, which I was really impressed to see. Granted, it is probably a very small trickle, but at least it is getting something. All right, so I want to show you guys right now, this is the side of the house with the shade on it. Look at this guy up here in the shade, and it is still getting juice to the camera right now. It is 12:49. And we are still getting, in the shade, power to that camera, which is topping it off. That is awesome. Because the solar panel is so light and the mount is so heavy, I just stuck this in the gutter. The mount is weighing it down, and that way I'm able to get the best angle of sun for this front camera. Now, when I started this test, the camera had been up for about 6 weeks, and the battery was all the way down to 53%. Within the first day of testing, I got a 13% bump in battery life, and it took a total of 3 days to get this camera all the way up to 100%. And that is just with 3 hours of sun a day. So I loved seeing that. Taking a look at the camera that is actually in the backyard and probably getting the most sun of the day. With that camera getting a lot more sun, it only took that camera, which was about the same, about 50%. It took that one about a day and a half to get all the way up to 100%. So as awesome as these are and as quick as they are at charging my cameras, do they provide me with those extra features? The answer, unfortunately, for both of those is no. Now, I talked to Arlo about it and asked if maybe there was just something wrong with my setup. They said, unfortunately, this does not provide enough power to be able to turn on the feature for activity zones or that 3-second look back. So don't count on those features using the solar panel. Overall, I have been using these solar panels now for, I think it's 9 months, and I have not had to change the battery at all. There was a scenario when we had about a week and a half of a storm roll in. It was rainy, it was windy all the time. I have got a table in the backyard that has a cover on it, and with the wind blowing that, I was constantly getting motion notifications in the backyard camera that actually drained my battery all the way down to, I think it was like 35% after a week and a half. And I was really bummed out. I was not getting any sun because of all the rain. But what I ended up doing because of the storm is I actually just turned that camera off. I was tired of getting all the notifications and I knew that was just draining the battery. Once the sun came back out and the storm was gone, I turned the camera back on and it took about 2 days to fully charge the battery in the backyard, which was fine. So you just got to keep in mind, if you're dealing with a storm or something like that, you may have to turn the camera off just to prevent it from just going completely dead. At least that's what I had to do in my scenario this past winter. But other than that, I haven't had to touch them. They've been awesome. They've been keeping everything powered up. I am happy with them. I will say though, at $80 each, that is a hard pill to swallow. But what do you guys think? What's the scenario that you are in where this would just be absolutely fantastic? Do you have it up high in a tree or on the second story of your house that's not easy to get to, that you'd rather just set these and forget it and just know that they're going to stay powered all the time? Or is replacing a battery worth saving the money and not having to spend something like this? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to know what you guys think. If you guys would like to see more from me, check out my channel, Steve Does, where I do smart home videos as well as other tech. Also, if this video is helpful, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. Let me know that you liked it. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell for more videos like this one. I want to thank you guys again for joining me here at reviews.org, and I'll see you in the next one.